Hello, welcome to Flipped. So today we'll be talking about organic chemistry. This is actually a quite easy chapter, especially the first part of this organic chemistry chapter. Probably the only tough part is some students may find it difficult to, differentiate the difference between all these terms like fuel, petroleum, crude oil, and natural gas. So today we'll be just exploring the overview of it and how to actually differentiate them. Okay, so let's begin. So actually, fuel is really just something that is burned to produce energy. So the key term here is burn. So you can see that I didn't put a picture here because I didn't want to confuse you guys with what's a fuel. Because fuel can exist in many forms. Okay, in O-level syllabus, it only exists, okay, it is simplified into just two forms, which is petroleum and natural gas. So petroleum is the same as crude oil. So this one, please take note. And the other one being natural gas. And this is the one we'll focus heavily on, especially in the next part. Okay, so what's the difference between petroleum slash crude oil and natural gas? First of all, petroleum is a thick black liquid. So you can see here in the picture. Okay, it's very thick, it's very viscous, and it contains a mixture of hydrocarbons. So what's hydrocarbons? Okay, for those who are new to this chapter, hydrocarbons just means that whatever compound that is being labeled a hydrocarbon, it only contains C's, which is carbon, and hydrogen. So that's what it means to be a hydrocarbon. So for example, C7H14 is a hydrocarbon because it only contains C and H. What about C8H20? Okay, this is also hydrocarbon because it only contains C and H. But if we put C, for example, 7H2O, this is not hydrocarbon because now the compound contains oxygen. Okay, so for it to be a hydrocarbon, it has to be purely made up of carbon and hydrogen only. Okay, so back to this. So petroleum is a mixture of all these hydrocarbons, and it can be separated by this very important technique, fractional distillation, which we will talk about in the second part of this chapter. Okay, next, let's move on to natural gas. So natural gas is, in gas, in this case, you cannot see it. So when it burns, okay, but it burns. So you'll be able to see that the flames arise from here, okay? And this happens at the stove of a house, for example. So you cannot see the gas, but you can see that it burns, okay? And it fits the definition of a fuel because it's able to burn to produce energy, okay? So for natural gas, the only thing you have to remember is that it's colorless and it's mainly methane, okay? So a possible question they will ask you is that, oh, name one natural gas. Okay, and the answer you can just give would be CH4. Okay, but in this case, please don't write it like that. Please write it in the form of CH with a lowercase 4. Okay, now let's move on to combustion. Okay, so combustion, the term combustion really just means to burn. So the term combustion really just means to burn crude oil or natural gas, because in your syllabus, these are the only two things you can burn in some sense. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, so you only have to know that you can burn these two things, okay, to produce heat energy. Okay, so this is the meaning of combustion, when you burn the compounds that we mentioned above. Okay, so there are two ways to combust something. First one is complete combustion. Second one being incomplete combustion. So first one is complete. Second one is incomplete. So what's the difference between these two? So the first one is complete combustion only happens in an environment that has sufficient oxygen. Okay, that means it's, for example, open air or somewhere that's not restricting the flow of air, for example. Ok Okay, whereas in incomplete combustion, okay, oxygen supply will be insufficient. Okay, this can be in places such as like a very small room or when you put a blanket over something that's caught on fire. Okay, and so that's how you put out a fire actually. Okay, so the difference between them in terms of oxygen level is that it has to be sufficient for complete combustion. It's insufficient for incomplete combustion. Okay, so now let's talk about the products they produce. In complete combustion, you only get two products. The first one being carbon dioxide and water. Okay, this is gaseous. This is also gaseous. Okay, so this is not water per se. This is actually water vapor. Okay, so these are the only two products you will get in a complete combustion. Whereas in an incomplete combustion, you will get a variety of products. For example, you will get carbon, okay, carbon monoxide, or carbon dioxide. Okay, you really won't know. Okay, so it's actually a or. Okay, and you will also get water vapor. Okay, so this is the thing about the combustion portion is that schools or exam papers can never ask you to predict. Okay, you can actually predict if they give you an incomplete equation, chemical equation, but they cannot ask you to predict from without any knowledge what products you will get from incomplete combustion, because in the real world, there's really no way to tell what you will get, like how many portion, what's the percentage of this or this. Okay, so that's a question that won't come up, but when they ask you to predict what's the percentage of the following. Okay, but in the case of complete combustion, you have to know that only these two will come out. Only these two will be produced, so you have to know the products. Okay, the final one will be to show you some examples of a complete combustion. Okay, so here I have methane, which is, as you can recall, is CH4 gas, okay, plus 2 oxygen. This will give me carbon dioxide, gas, and water. Okay, as you can see, only two products are produced, which is only CO2 and H2O. Okay, whereas for incomplete combustion, there's really no way to tell what is being produced. So there are a few examples. Let me show you just two. First one is using methane. So it's 2 CH4 gaseous plus 3 oxygen, giving you 2 carbon monoxide gaseous plus 4 units of water. Okay, that's just one of the many examples. Let me show you another one. So in this case, I have the same thing, okay? Same methane plus O2 gaseous giving me carbon. In this case, it's a soot. Okay, it's the black carbon that you see sometimes, and H2O. Okay, so these are the difference between complete combustion and incomplete combustion, in that, okay, firstly they exist in different levels of oxygen. Okay, second, they give different products. Okay, and lastly, okay, complete combustion gives fixed products, whereas incomplete combustion will give a variety of products. Okay, you can see carbon monoxide here and carbon here. Okay,